Solve the system of equations. X plus y plus z equals 4, x minus 2y minus z equals 1, 2x minus y minus 2z equals negative 1. Now remember, we're going to take the coefficients of all the x's, the y's, and the z's, and the constants, and put those into an augmented matrix. And then ultimately, we are going to want that matrix to look like this, where we have this diagonal of ones and then some values a, b, and c, and those will be our values of x, y, and z. So x, 1 times x equals a, 1 times y equals b, and z equals c. All right, let's start by writing the augmented matrix for this system of equations. We have 1, 1, 2, 1, negative 2, negative 1 going down these columns, and 1, negative 1, negative 2 for the z coefficients, and for the constants we have 4, we have 1, and we have negative 1. All right, we want to get this diagonal of 1s. When it's a system of two equations, I like to work on the zeros first, but it's going to be easier with the system of three equations to work on the ones and then get your zeros. So I'm going to get a 1 right here, and I already have it, so I'm good there. Now I want zeros here. So what can I do? What can I add to this second row to get a 0? And more specifically, what multiple of this first row can I add? Well, 1 plus negative 1 equals 0. So I'm going to say here, negative 1 times row 1 plus row 2 will replace row 2. Now, before I write the result, let's ask ourselves, what multiple of this first row can I add to the second row to get to the third row? What can I add to the third row to get 0? Well, 1 times negative 2 gives us negative 2, and that's what we need to add here. So I'm going to say negative 2 times row 1 plus row 3 replaces row 3. Now, to keep track of this, I like to make a note of what I'm doing. I'm adding negative 1, negative 1, negative 1. That's all of these 1s times the negative 1. And I'm adding negative 4. That's on the row 2. On row 3, let's change colors so you can see it a little better. On row 3, I'm adding negative 2. Negative 2, negative 2, and negative 2 times 4 is negative 8. Okay, let's write the result. We did not replace row 1, so that's going to stay 1, 1, 1, and then 4. We get a 0. Negative 2 plus negative 1 is negative 3. Negative 1 and negative 1 is negative 2. And 1 minus 4 is negative 3. That's our second row. Third row, negative 2, or 2 and negative 2 is 0. That's good. We have our zeros in that column. That's what we're trying to accomplish. Now the rest of the row, negative 1 and negative 2 is negative 3. Negative 2 and negative 2 is negative 4. And negative 1 and negative 8 is negative 9. All right. We've got that matrix going in our the way we want it. Now we're thinking, how can we get this middle number to equal 1? Because remember, we want this form here of the second row. Well, if we multiply by the reciprocal, we'll get a 1 there. So negative 1/3 times row 2 will replace row 2. Let's write the result, and that is 1, 1, 1, 4. First row is not affected. We have 0, 1, negative 2 times negative 1 third is negative or positive 2 thirds. And we have negative 1 third times 3 is positive 1. Let's extend this matrix down. And now we have row 3 was not affected. We didn't do anything to that one. So I'll just write what we had above. Okay, now we want zeros here and here. We have the one that we wanted there. Now we need zeros here. So I'm going to say, what do I have multiplied by 1 to get negative 1, so we can cancel this one out, and that's negative 1. So I'll show that. I'll say negative 1 times row 2 plus row 1 will replace row 1. And what can I multiply by 1 to get positive 3 so that I can cancel this out? And that is, it's going to be 3. 3 times row 2 plus row 3 will replace row 3. So in the interest of time, I'm just going to jump to that. You could write your little notation like I did here in the purple. So let's see, 1 times negative 1 plus 1. Let's see here, 0. I get a 1 here. I get a 0 here. And then 2 thirds times negative 1 is negative 2 thirds plus a 1. You know what? I am going to write this notation. It sure does make it easier to follow. So this is minus 2 thirds and minus 1 up here. And down on the, well, let's just keep finishing this row. So I'm going to have a 1 third there. And 4 minus 1 is 3. Second row was not changed. We only used some multiple of it, but we didn't change it. We didn't replace the second row. And then the third row, what am I adding on to that? I'm adding 3 times the first row, so plus a 3. 3 times 2 thirds is a 2, a positive 2, and 3 times 1 is 3. All right, the result then in row 3 is 0, 0. Negative 4 and 2 is negative 2. Negative 9 and 3 is negative 6. All right, let's see if I can move this down just a tiny bit so you can see that a little better. Okay. Now, what am I going to do to, we've got a couple of rows done. What am I going to do to get a 1 right here? I want a 1 where this negative 2 is. Again, multiply by the reciprocal. So negative 1 half times row 3 will replace row 3. And I'm going to bring that all the way up to the top here. Thank goodness, because we're running out of room. And first and second row are staying the same. 1, 0, 1 third, and 3. And then 0, 1, 2 thirds, and 1. And the last line, 0 times negative 1 half, and 0 times negative 1 half. And then negative 2 times negative 1 half gives us our 1. And now negative 6 times negative 1 half gives you positive 3. All right. Now, what multiple of 1 would we use to get zeros? To get zeros here and here. All right. That's going to be, for the first row, I'll say negative 1 third. Negative 1 third of row 3 plus row 1 will replace row 1. And negative 2 thirds of row 3. Negative 2 thirds of row 3 plus row 2 will replace row 2. And a little notation of what's going on here. I'm adding, because these are zeros, this is, starts to get easier and easier, because negative 1 third times these zeros is just 0, 0. Negative 1 third times 1 is the negative 1 third. Whoops, negative 1 third. Negative 1 third times 3 is negative 1. So that's what we're adding to the first row. And on the second row, I'm going to get a different color. I'm adding 0 and 0. And onto this 2 thirds, I am adding negative 2 thirds. And onto the 1, I am adding negative 1. That is, oh, I'm sorry, negative 2 thirds of 3 is negative 2. Negative 2. Okay. We'll write that nice and tidy here. 1, 0, 0. Adding these, that's adding these, we get 0. And 3 and negative 1 is 2. And then we get 0, 1, 2 thirds, and negative 2 thirds is 0. And 1 minus 2 is negative 1. Row 3 stays the same. We did not change anything with row 3 on this step. And in the end, we've got 2, negative 1, 3. So x equals 2, y equals negative 1, and z equals 3. And that is the Gauss-Jordan elimination method to solve a system of 3 equations.